Hey everybody, this is Eric Clark's Travel Videos, and I'm at San Domenico Maggiore. It's a church from the 1300s that's lasted all this time. So I'll take you inside and I'll show you around as always. And I'm trying to break it up, but there's just so many churches. But I found a cemetery to go to and a few other things. Anyway, come on, we'll go look. Bye. Okay. And here's what it says. This is where I'm at, San Domenico Maggiore. I think it has some famous things, but as always, they're written in English. But it looks really pretty. Huh? Oh, okay. Donations. Okay. Thank you. Grazie. America. So, where is this at? I don't understand. Okay. Well, here's the way this went. She said it's closed until Friday at 10. And then I came back and she just kept sticking that basket in my face. And so I guess I realized that she wanted money. And so I gave her 5 euros and then she said I could see the place. So as the nickel turns the world, this is 1676. Tickles my fancy. It reminds me of Egypt. When I was in Egypt, they wanted a dollar for you to breathe. And everywhere you went was money. And even in some of the crypts where it said, like King Tut's tomb, there are no pictures, forbidden picture, forbidden picture. Well, you give him $5 or something, he'd let you take a video. And so I think I spent $100 giving $5 here and $5 there to every single person that was there. And it was heinous. And so this was, it's like a shakedown, you know? You wanna take a picture? Give us money. So anyway, I'll stop yapping. So, rule of thumb though, if you go to Egypt, oh man, take probably $200 in $5 bills and then put them all somewhere else and then just have a pocket with a couple of fives in it. And that way when you pull it out, because they'll take the five. If they see a 10, they're gonna ask for 10. And so I learned that one too, you know? I was in King Tut's tomb and I wanted to take a video and he saw that I had a 20. And then he just refused, almost threw me out. And then I gave him the 20, and then I was good to go. And none of this is in English, so but that's the way it was through all of Egypt. Wow, beautiful church. And I wish some of these were in English. I know. Because, I mean, some of these things are, can you read? I mean, it's Francisco whatever, Del Nota, so it's obviously famous, or they wouldn't document it. This one, too. I guess that thing up there is famous. I don't know. Okay. I gotta get my hands out of the bars. It's a pretty church. It's a big church. Altar too. If you speak Italian, your $5 is waived. That's just the way it goes. What is this thing? Entrada? Museum itinerary? And is that this stuff? Museum? Well, maybe the museum's closed. Send them in with my curry. And it looks like sacristy, sacred furnishing rooms, €5. Furnishing rooms, €7. Interesting. Museum open? No, open? No, okay, not yet, okay. 5 more will open the museum. And then you gotta pay 5. Cappella del Crocifisso. Certainly lots to see here, so. And what does this one say? So this must be famous somewhere. Here we go, something in English. On the 8th century altar, a painting showing Saint Catherine and Saint Raimondo by Gabriel Farnese, dating back to the 19th century. And that must be that. Now, Farnese, isn't he the one who did the veiled Christ as well? I think he did. This chapel was dedicated to Anthony Abbott, portrayed in 1585. I tell you, I got a new phone on the way. So this one was 1585. See how it doesn't focus? So if I click the screen, then it'll focus. looks like each one of his little rooms has something. What does this one say? Click the screen. This table belongs to the Capisi family, 16th century, the crucifix, blah, blah, blah. Huh. And where's that one at? That's the lion. Oops. I guess the lion's been removed. It looks like it went right there. These frescoes say. Chapel shows the frescoes by the Roman painter Pietro Cavallanani. Blah, 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 blah. Left to the top. And it's funny. Put in a dollar and we'll turn on the lights for you. We'll see what a dollar gets you. So this is it without a light. And that lady's digging in her purse right now for a dollar. Oh, maybe not. Huh. Oh, glasses. It's getting dark in here, huh? Come on, phone. 4th century. Racanano family? Huh. And I would assume that that's the... stuff. And this one says, amazing ceiling. Big ceiling. can see it, and I'm all reading it, and you guys can't read it. There we go. Crappy little phone. This one says something interesting, I don't know. Capella Dova. Okay, so this is the one, that's the Caravaggio, designed by Caravaggio. See that there? Let's see if it says something about it here. Here we go. This chapel belongs to the Francis family, the astounding Flavelio by Caravaggio, currently in the art gallery at Cavera, was replaced by a wooden statue. Oh, so I guess this isn't the actual Caravaggio? A wooden statue? Floor's amazing. You know, would we even know? You could tell us it's a Caravaggio. You could tell us it was painted by Da Vinci in it. I don't know that it would matter much, huh? Phone's getting worse. Well, maybe too, because the lighting's not 100% perfect. This one says the Chapel of St. Bartholomew. It's certainly a huge church. Okay, everybody. This is the actual church. I'll come back into the museum, I guess, on Friday. Bye, everybody.